Hi guys, this is John here, and in today's lecture, we will be looking at an introduction to 3D, also known as three-dimensional. So let's get started. So before we understand 3D, let us first understand what we mean by 2D. So if you look at the image of this car, what all can you see? You can see one headlight, you can see one front tire, you can see one back tire, you can see one tail light, and you can see one side view mirror. Let's look at another view of the car. Now, if we look at another image, we look at a car from another view, we see that we can see two side view mirrors, we can see two front tires, and we can see two front headlights. But can you see the rear tires? We cannot. So this image versus this image, there are some differences. Why is that? Let us look at another perspective of looking at the car. Now let us look at this view. If you look at this view, you can see two front lights, you can see the front tire, you can see the rear tire, you can see the side view mirrors. Now, when you compare this to the images that we saw before, in this view, we can see more aspects of the car compared to the images that we saw before, images 1 and 2. Again, why is that? Let us look at this view. In this view, I can see one front tire, I can see two back tires, I can see two tail lights, I can see one rear view mirror. Again, if you compare it to image 1 and 2, can we see more aspects of the car? Yes or no? The answer is yes. Now let us look at why. So before we move on to why, let us quickly summarize what we've just discussed. In this image of the car, we could see one headlight, one front tire, one side view mirror, one tail light, and one back tire. Versus in this image, I could see two headlights, two side view mirrors, and two front tires. Now in this image, I could see two front lights with a rear tire, I could see two side view mirrors with a rear tire and a front tire. So we could see more aspects here. And if you look at this view, again, we could see more aspects of the car. Now let us look at this image again. If you look at this image, I can see the height of the car and I can see the length of the car. Both the height and length are called dimensions. You can also say this is the length, and again, this is my height. And as we saw before, the height and length are known as dimensions, and in short, we call them D. So can you count how many dimensions are there in this view? I count one, and I count two. So we will call this image a 2D image or a 2D view of your car. So let's call this a 2D view of your car. Okay. Again, now let us look at another image. Here, again, as you see, there is height, but now there is width. As we know, the height and the width are known as dimensions. In short, we call them D. And hence, can you count how many dimensions are there in this image? We have 1 and we have 2. So we have a total of 2 dimensions in this image. So I shall call this a 2D image or a 2D view of my car. So what did we see? This image and this image are 2D images. Why are they 2D images? Because we can see only 2 dimensions. In this particular image, we could see the height and the length. Whereas in this image, we could see the height and the width. Now let us compare these images with the images we saw before, where we could see more aspects. This image and this image. Now, if I look at this image of the car, in this image, I have the height, I have the length, and I have the width. The height is one dimension, the length is another dimension, and the width is the third dimension. So total, how many dimensions do we have? We have 3 dimensions. So this view of my car, I will call it my 3D view or also my 3D image. Again, let us revise. Because we have 3 dimensions, namely your height, length, and width, I am able to say that this view of my car is a 3D view. So basically, what are we trying to say? That when we have a 2D image or a 2D view, which is this one, you have a certain number of aspects that you can see. Versus when you have a 3D view, you can see more aspects to the same part compared to your 2D. So in short, if you have 3D images, they have more aspects, or now we will use the word more details compared to your 3D. Why did we say that? Again, let's compare. In this view, I could see one front tire, one headlight, one tail light, one back tire. Whereas here, I could see one front tire, one rear tire, 2 front lights, 2 side views. So you could see more aspects here. Whereas in this view, you could not see the rear. In this view, you could not see the rear tire. Whereas here, you could see the rear tire. Again, as I'm saying, in 3D, you can see more detail as compared to 2D. So let us understand, 3D has more detail as compared to 2D. Okay. So I hope you guys are clear on this. In the next lecture, we will look at a short exercise on 2D versus 3D. So I hope this was clear. If you have doubts, please feel free to write to us. I shall see you guys in the next lecture. Thank you.